He knows a lot about the science stuff, Professor Dave Explains.
Hey guys, for today's problem, we've got a little bit of a synthesis-oriented challenge. What we want to do is we've got our trans-butene, and we want to get to a cis-butene in three steps. And so using the techniques you know, let's see if you can get from this to this in three steps. Okay, so let's talk about how we're going to do this. We've got our trans-2-butene. We want to get to our cis-2-butene. Now, obviously, this is not a very practical question. These are both readily available, so no one would actually do this in a lab. But it's a nice little thought experiment to test us and see if we can comb through our toolkit of reactions and see if we can figure out a strategy, a way to do this. And so we might look at the product and say, all right, well, we want to get a cis-alkene. We want to get a Z-alkene. Now, what ways do I know how to do that? Well, I know that I can do a selective hydrogenation of an alkyne, right? We know how to do hydrogenation of an alkyne to specifically get a Z alkene. And so now we're left with the task of how do we get to an alkyne so that we can do that? Okay, well, what methods do I know in order to get an alkyne? Well, we know that we can generate pi bonds through elimination reactions. But we would need to do two of them. So maybe we're starting to piece things together. We can take a look at this and we can say, all right, well, what am I going to do to set myself up for a situation where I can get an alkyne? So what if we do a dihalogenation, right? What if we do, let's just use bromine, and we would probably use maybe CCl4 right there. And so what's going to happen there? Well, we would get a dibromo product right there. Right, so we know that we can do dihalogenation and we're going to get to there. So why is that useful? Because we know another technique whereby we can get from this kind of molecule to the alkyne by doing two successive eliminations. Right, so what method do we know that will help us do that? Well, we would need a base. We'd need a pretty strong base. Let's say we use NaNH2, and we need two equivalents because we're going to do two eliminations, right? And we might run that in mineral oil. And so we are going to go, right, NH2 minus, a very, very strong base. That's going to go and grab a proton, do one elimination. Then it is going to go grab the other proton, do the other elimination. And we are going to get to that alkyne, right? We're going to get to that alkyne that we wanted, right? And so we knew we were going to do that because we had this strategy in mind. We that was the first thing we thought of. We thought the best way to get that Z-alkene is by hydrogenation. And if we remember, what is our method for doing that? We might remember that we're going to use Lindler's catalyst, right? Lindler's catalyst is going to selectively hydrogenate the alkyne to the Z-alkene. So this is an excellent little problem in terms of looking at something that looks like we haven't even really done very much, but then having to sift through our toolkit of reactions and try to figure out a strategy. So we've got our dihalogenation and then elimination twice to get the alkyne and then Lindler's catalyst to get us to the Z-alkene. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.